Asante kutusimamisha Mungu wakati kama huu. Asante asante kutuondolea laana, asante kutuondolea vikwazo, asante kutuondolea limitation zote zilizowekwa na yule mwovu shetani. Tunakuinua juu mfalme, tunakutukuza kimbilio la maisha yetu, tunasema asante maana umepigana vita vyetu kama kanisa. Ewe Mungu wangu, hujatuaibisha, hujatuachanisha mfalme. Pokea sifa na utukufu siku ya leo katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Roho Mtakatifu wa Mungu, tunainama chini ya ukuu wa jina lako, tukisema ulinipa sifa milele, kwa maana unastahili sifa za mioyo yetu. Asante maana wewe ni Mungu, asante maana wewe ni kimbilio. Tunakupa sifa, tunakuheshimu na tunakutukuza kimbilio letu. Thank you Lord, thank you Holy Spirit of God. You are the only key that opens every closed door of our life, dear Master. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. We love you for your presence in the service today. We love you, Dara Mazekete, Raboshika, Dara Babosiate, Rikaya Makata, Raboshikete, Raboshiate, Rikaya Takaya Mazekete, Raboshika, Taya Raba, Rikeshere, Makandi, Raboshikete, Raboshiaka, Rikataya Mazekete. Tukupa sifa, heshima, utukufu Mungu wetu. Asante kwa kusimama nasi mfalme. Pokea sifa kwa kutupona mioyo yetu. Wengine wetu tulikuwa tumewekwa vidonda na mwovu shetani. Baba ni asante maana umetupona. Wengine wetu tulienda chini ukatuinua tena mfalme. Pokea sifa za mioyo yetu Mungu shetani sana. Asante Yesu maana shetani alipokuja uliinua Mungu kwa standard of our lives, King Jesus. We love you today. We love you forever, Son of God. Thank you. Thank you for dying for us on the cross. We love you, Jesus. Because you are the King. For this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let's celebrate the Lord Jesus for his love, for his mercies upon our lives. And let me give the Lord a happy platform to give some worship and we take their seat also. May the Lord bless you dearly and continue doing you good. Praise the Lord, Church. Bon Jesus, if you will. I trust Jehovah that you've been fine all along, the entire week, those we were with on Wednesday and those who were last week on Sunday. I bless the Lord to see you again, and to our visitors who are visiting for the first time, may the Lord do you good. May he work on you as you sit there and listen to him. And I pray that may every expectation of your heart these hours of the morning will not be cut off in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. My name is Reverend George. Jesus has saved me this morning, has given me the grace to stand here and to confess that he is God who saves and sustains what he has saved. He saved me long time ago. He has sustained that salvation. He has grown me in him. I am a work in progress in his service every day. And that one has given me the privilege to serve him with a lot of passion. And I always find light in doing that which brings glory to my God. Praise the Lord. And that's why I'm so happy this wonderful morning to see each one of you. And as we bless the Lord that he has been answering our prayers, he has been listening to us. We've been praying. First, when the churches were told to close, we prayed and cried to God that they can be at least be reopened. They were reopened with strict measures, and we complained to start, and we told God, see, this one is not enough. We still need our freedom to worship the Lord Jesus. It is still progressing. We have been added another that minute to the 1 hour that the government had given to us. Praise the Lord. We are still blessing the name of Jesus, and also the limitation from 13 and below has been lifted from 6 and up to 60, from 6 years to through 65. So we are thanking God. Whoever is 58 and you are at home, you are not allowed to come back to church, apart from those who are 65. And even to them, we are continuing praying our God, who is never limited, that even this one is going to be removed to the glory and honor of our God. Hallelujah. And those who have been following the news, you can see still, the recovery rate is higher than the dead rate. Amen? And we are thanking God because every prayer we are praying, Jehovah is listening to those prayers. So let us continue praying for those who are suffering from the COVID-19 pandemic, those who are tested positive, those already have been affected. Dearly, we pray for them that the Lord will heal them completely and will bring this one to an end because he is God. Hallelujah. So as a minister, I feel blessed to stand here to thank God to most of you members for your participation, your support in every activity of the church and any other that you called upon. I have seen you doing it with a lot of love and generosity, and may the Lord bless you for that. Amen. Let God go to the word of God. We are reading from the book of Acts of Apostles, chapter 27, verse 13 through 25, through 26. Acts of Apostles 27, 13 through 26. If you are there, you can say amen. Meaning we are not there, I'll still give you a chance to go to the book of Acts. It is the fourth book in the New Testament. Chapter 27 is the second last chapter of that book. It has 28 chapters. And we are reading from verse 13 through 26. I'll read. The storm of the sea. When a light wind began blowing from the south, the sailors thought they could make it. So they pulled of grapes. But the weather changed abruptly, and a wind of a typhoon, a strengthened, called a wind a northeaster, passed across the island and they blew out to sea. The sailors couldn't turn the ship into the wind. They gave up and let it run before the gale. We sailed along the shattered side of a small island named Clauda, Acauda. Where with great difficulty we hoisted abroad, the lifeboat being towed behind us. The sailors bowled ropes around the hull of the ship to strengthen it. They were afraid of being driven across to the sandbars of the Surtees of the African coast. So they lowered the sea anchor to slow the ship and were driven before at the wind. The next day, as a gale force winds continued to batter the ship, the crew began throwing the cargo overboard. The following day, they even took some of the ship's gear and threw it overboard. The terrible storm raged for many days, blotting out the sun and the stars until at last all hope was gone. Verse 21, no one had eaten for a long time. Finally, Paul called the crew together and said, "Men, you should have listened to me in the first place and not left Crete. You would have avoided all this damage and loss. But take courage. None of you will lose your lives, even though the ship will go down. For last night, an angel of the Lord, to whom I belong and whom I serve, stood beside me. And he said, 'Do not be afraid, Paul, for you will surely stand trial before Caesar. God in his goodness has granted safety to everyone sailing with you. So take courage, for I believe God, it will be just as he said.'" Verse 26, "But we'll be shipwrecked on an island." Let's move to Luke chapter 8, verse 22. Luke chapter 8, verse 22. One day Jesus said to the disciples, let's cross the other side of the lake. So they got into a boat and they started out. As they sailed across, Jesus settled down for a nap. But as soon as a fierce storm came down on the lake, and the boat was filling with water, and they were in real danger, the disciples went and woke him up, saying or shouting, "Master, Master, we are going to drown." When Jesus woke up, he rebuked the winds and the raging waves. Suddenly, the storm stopped and all was calm. Then he asked them, "Where is your faith?" The disciples, terrified and amazed, "Who is this man?" they asked each other. When he gives a command, even the winds and the waves obey him. Father in heaven, in Jesus' name, we are here in your presence, Lord, ready to hear from you that which you put in the heart of your servant, O God, that you may deliver it in accordance to your will and wish in heaven, in the name of Jesus, that you may bless somebody, lift somebody, Jehovah, encourage somebody, and give hope to that hopeless soul that is listening and watching us from wherever they are, in the name of Jesus, that we pray and we give thanks. Amen. The message of today is hope in the storm. Hope in the storm. Hallelujah. Tell the person that is 1.5 meters away from you, hope in the storm. Hope in the storm. Now, I'll start by defining what is hope. Hope is an expectation that everything is going to be all right. Hope is an expectation that everything is going to be all right. Number two, hope is the divine part of us that keeps our eyes focused on the horizons ahead and helps us to look towards tomorrow. Hope is the divine part of us that keeps our eyes focused on the horizons ahead and helps us to look towards tomorrow. Meaning, hope is that thing that helps the divine part of you that has been put and inserted by God in your heart, that helps you to keep on hoping that tomorrow things changes from the way they are today. That tomorrow things become better than they are today. That tomorrow this mountain gonna change from here, it will pave away for me, and I'm going to break through to this road that I'm following in the name of Jesus. So number three, hope is the life cord that sustains us through the storms we encounter. Hope is a life cord that sustains us through the storms that we encounter. Hope is that life cord. Life cord is a cord that holds you at your life, that helps you to propel and to every challenge, every storm of life. In life, we face so many challenges. In life, we find so many storms. In life, there are all manner of things that bring us down. But the hope is a life cord that helps you to hold on, to go through, to sail through to that challenge that you encounter in life. And number four, hope is a fizz, F-I-Z-Z, that keeps life from going flat. Hope is a fizz that keeps life from going flat. You know, especially in this period, this pandemic period,
And things are, at times, they are getting tougher every day. We are trying to look for a way out, and at times it seems so difficult for us. But now, what is holding us in this difficult situation? It is not yourself. It is the hope that you profess in God. It is the hope that you hope in the Lord Jesus that is holding you, that you could not go flat. That despite that today I am spending angry, tomorrow things are becoming better. That today I have been laid off from the place I've been working. Tomorrow Jesus is opening a way for me. Today their door has closed for me. Tomorrow there is another one that Jehovah is opening for his own glory. Today I have received the bad news concerning my relative, my situation, my people, my family. But tomorrow I have a new report from the Lord that says it is possible with him who believes. Praise the Lord. But there is what is true. And now for hope to stand strong, for hope to stand strong, it must have the support of three things. That is number one, faith, confidence, knowledge, and then number four, expectations or anticipation. For hope to stand strong, it must be supported by faith, confidence, knowledge, and expectation stroke anticipation. And now I'll define what is faith. When you read from the book of Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1, the Bible says, faith is the assurance on title deed, confirmation of things hoped for, divinely guaranteed, and the evidence of the things not seen, the conviction of the reality. Faith comprehends as a fact what cannot be experienced by the physical sense. Faith is that thing that makes you believe things which are not there, although they are there. I am here as the minister of the gospel. I am telling you there is God. I am telling you there is Jesus. I have never seen God with my eyes. I have never seen Jesus. I have experienced God, and I have experienced Jesus. Amen? And now still I am giving you a conviction that there is God, that there is heaven, where we are going after this. Hallelujah. So it is hope, it is faith that is making me come strongly to tell you, you know what? You need to hope in the Lord. You need to keep on trusting upon God, because one of these fine days, Jesus is coming for us. Are we going to go home? Hallelujah. It is faith that is making me to encourage you amid this of the challenges, problems that I am in, to tell you, you know what? Today you are going through this way, but tomorrow, things are moving out to offer you the glory and honor of our God. Hallelujah. So for our faith, for our hope to stand strong amid this the storm, it must be supported by faith. Hallelujah. When you read the stories of Jesus and the disciples and the many people that Jesus healed, there is none of them that we see who was healed out of lack of faith. They were healed because of their faith. And Jesus says, daughter or son, your faith has made you well. And one of the things that challenges me, the story of the paralytic man. When the four people brought this guy and they tried to push through the door, they could not make their way through where Jesus was. They decided to go up the ceiling and to the roof and remove some iron sheet. And they dropped the paralytic man or the paralyzed man in the front of Jesus where he was teaching. And the Bible says, Jesus looking at the faith of the four, not of the faith of the man. Hallelujah. Akashindwa, mbona wakusukumana waingie mpaka hapa waliona bana. Kusukumana inaweza chukua muda. Yesu afanye nini? Probably akuwa maliza mahubiri yake na akaanza kutoka. So what do we do? Tutapanda huko juu ya mabati, tumoize mabati, tumwangushie hapo. Akifika hapo yeye atashughulika na yeye. Bwana sifiwe. Ndivyo ndivyo Yesu alivyofanya. No, the four people they did. Hallelujah. So we hope that after we take this guy before the Lord, Jesus is going to work on him. And truth to the word of God is, at the moment they dropped this man in the presence of Jesus, he worked on him. Remember the woman with an issue of blood. Before she came to Jesus, she visited many places for help she didn't get. Na akaamua moyoni mwake. Biblia inasema, alikaa chini na akaamua kwa moyo wake. Nitafanya nini? Chenye nitafanya kitu kimoja. If I go and touch the helm of the garment of Jesus, nikienda tu niguze vazi la Yesu, mimi na tu ugonjwa wangu na mashina nilizo nazo zinaelekea kuisha. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Alikombine a faith and a hope ni tumaini. Alikuwa kwa mashina, yes. Akaona kwa haya mashina niliyo nayo, nitaweka imani, nitainua imani yangu na tumaini langu kwa Mungu ambaye huo upeane uponyaji. Bwana asifiwe. Let's proceed. Now, we have read two different stories. One of the stories we read, it is Jesus with the disciples across crossing the lake. And Jesus, because he was human being also, and partially he was human being and was God, he got tired and he took a nap. And as they were sailing through the lake, or they were crossing the lake, there came a storm in the lake. Nilipokuta, mawimbi yakakuwa mengi na kaanza kutoss the ship from this end, not the ship, the boat, from this end to the other end. And the disciples, they were like, here we are perishing. Hallelujah. And now they were like, well, what we do? We have no power of ourselves. We have no strength to do anything in this storm. But we have one thing that we can do. They remembered their hope in the Lord. They remembered their helper. They remembered the person they put their faith into. And this is Jesus Christ, the Son of God. They went and they woke him up. They told him, Jesus, please wake up and help us. We are almost drowning. The moment Jesus rise from his sleep, he rebuked the wind and the storm. And the Bible said there was great calm. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Mpendwa nikuulize, ni mawimbi gani hayo ambayo yameingilia maisha yako, ameanza kukupeleka upande ule, upande ule mwingine. Unajaribu kuomba unashindwa. Unajaribu kuita jina la Yesu unashindwa. Na kumbuka ya kwamba Biblia inasema atakayeliitia jina la Yesu ataokolewa. Wakati mawimbi yamekuzunguka upande ule, upande ule mwingine, usikubali kuteremsha imani yako. Usikubali kusikiza wanaoongea. Kubali kumsikiza aliyekuita na anayekuambia kwake yeye yote yanawezekana. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So there is hope in every storm. Amen. And every storm that comes in our life, it doesn't come to finish us, it comes to display the power of God in our lives. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hayo mawimbi ambayo unapitia, hayajakuja dada na ndugu yangu kuangamiza. Yamekuja kuonyesha, kudhihirisha utukufu wa Mungu juu ya maisha yako. Tuko pamoja? Kile inahitajika hapa ni wewe ukainua imani yako na ujue unayemtumainia ni nani. Na jina lake anaitwa Yesu. Bwana asifiwe. Kile kitu ambacho Mwenyezi Mungu anatamani kwako na kwako kama watoto wake ni kitu kimoja. Wakati unapitia haya mawimbi, usiende ukiambia kila mtu unapitia. Mwite yeye. He says, call unto me, I will answer you. Did he say, call unto Mutembei? No. Did he say, call unto any human being? Did he say, call any name, your mom or your dad or your husband or your wife? No. He said, what? Call unto me, him, God. He will answer us. The problem with me and you is one. We are not calling. And if we are calling, we are calling with the wrong motive. That's what James says. That the reason why my prayers and your prayers are sometimes are not answered, it is because we pray with the wrong motive. God, I pray that help me to go through this storm of COVID-19. Ili maandui zangu, especially jirani yangu asiyependa kuniona, akufe. Kuna akufe. Na Daudi alisema nini 23 Psalm? Alisema, Mungu naomba uniandalie mbele meza mbele ya maandui zangu. Mbona kuombea? Kuna mahali ameombea akufe, lakini 23 anaomba akufe. Sasa pia wewe unapoomba, usiombe watu waangamie, usiombe wakufe. Omba Mungu endelee kuishi. Jehova anapokuandalia meza after this COVID, utakuwa hapo watakuwa tu wakiona. Amen. Kuna wale wengine tumefungua, tukaribu kufungua nyumba. Area zimetufika hapa mpaka tumeweze kuambia sasa landlord what they are doing, they are negotiating with us. Wewe mtendee kulingana na nipo sasa ni vyema tu hama. Ukipata ukishipata pesa tu utaniletea. At least nipate mteja mwingine. Hiyo inaweza kuwa iko hapa kati yetu, usijali. Sawa sawa. Na kuna wale wengine washaa tu unapitia haya na umeanza kusambaza. Don't worry. Don't even pray for them to die. But pray that the Lord will keep them. So that when Jehovah takes you to your own house, not a rented one, to your own home, the Hosea there, like, okay, is it the same person when you call a rent as a house rent? But I suspect you. When you know your body, you know, 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 Professor wa kwamba washakufa tayari. Amen. Mbadi Mungu naye ni nani? Ataenda kuponya huyo uliye naye. Jehova atamuondoa katika kile kitanda cha hospitali. Na kimuondoa atapokea utukufu. Na watakuwa kwanza kuinua mikono kusema yenyewe ni kama Mungu amemponya. Praise the Lord. Do you remember the story of the Bartimaeus? What happened? The people told him to shut up. They are the same that Jesus used to tell him, call him for me. And they told him, cheer up, he's doing what? He's calling you. I have come to tell somebody that in the midst of the storms that we are in, there is Jesus in that storm. Bwana asifiwe. In the midst of every storm that you are going through, there is Jesus in that storm. So don't allow your eyes to see the storm. Allow your eyes to see Jesus in that storm. Kwa sababu I'm not guaranteeing that the storm won't come. They will come, even after today. Zingine zitakuja. Na zikija, hazikuji kumaliza. Zinakuja to display the power of God in your life. Bwana asifiwe. And as we go to the other reading that we've read, we have seen Paul is being taken to Rome. That is in Italy. He's taken there to be persecuted before Caesar. And as before they began the journey, he told them, please, it's not the appropriate time for us to sail through. Wawa kumisikia wa sababu walikuwa mfungwa. Akawambia ni sawa jumekata kumisikiza, let us move. And they started their journey. And from whatever we have read, you see what happened. There came a very bad storm in the sea. And they heard them traveling. For 14 days, they were in a storm. Hallelujah. But one beautiful thing about Paul was this. He knew his God. He knew whom he had put his trust into. He knew that the one who called me is so faithful to take me to the end. Hallelujah. And he understood when he wrote that I am confident that he who began the good work in me, he is so faithful to bring it to the end. People may not see the end of who, whatever he began in me. I may also try in a way not to see it, but he who began, because there's no new beginning, who began it, he is faithful to bring it to the end. But that is what he's doing. Mpendo aliyeanza kazi njema na nzuri juu ya maisha yako, aliyekuanzishia hiyo familia, aliyekupatia watoto, hiyo biashara inayoendelea kushuka chini kila siku, aliyeanzisha, yeye ni mwaminifu kuifikisha mwisho. Na si kuifikisha mwisho ifungwe, ni kuifikisha mwisho ikuwe nzuri zaidi ya jinsi ilivyokuwa. Ikifungua zingine, ndio utaanza kupewa zingine mpya. Bwana asifiwe. I remember 1994. Our mom and they had issues with dad, and she left to her sister's place in a far place. And when she went there, she stayed, and our uncle mwingine appeared to us if you kwa nini. He had issues with dad all along. He wanted to kill him. Today he has issues with me. I pray for him every day that Jesus changes him. Hallelujah. And one day God will change him. So this uncle of ours goes and starts spreading rumors that my mom is dead. And even he has seen dad carrying the coffin. So this one reaches us, we are like, okay, that didn't talk about, but in a school, we have a coffee. Yanani is like, when you need to talk about it, so your coffin, you know, the queen or the kind of wabi. So you know, the rumors, people started running to our home, they are crying, pulling inside, and we were like, what? You know, I and my brother, we ran all the way to the place our mom was. You know, that time there was no force, then 1984. As it requires, it doesn't come as it requires. You see, the umbani said, as it for me. No! That time, I was very tiny. We went there, and we found mom. She's like, oh, why are you so worried? We're like, we missed you. So we're like, okay, we must have like you and a home and anything. But the news of home is that she's dead. Me, I could not ahead. I don't know, mom. We have been told that you are dead and dad was seen carrying the coffin. So what you need to do, whatever it is between you and dad, you just leave, drop it, and you go home. She's like, no, you let us go home. Then we assure people that you're okay, because we've left people home. They are crying. Hallelujah. So that is the storm that came, and they hate us that time. But to cut the long story short, that we went home with mom, and people were like, they were fearing also even to come near her, because already she was dead and she was carried in a coffin. You know, all these. When I'm saying this, I know some people here who know already they were sharp prophesying you are dead. Wakakuangalia wakaono maisha. But what have been while prophesying? What did Jesus prophesy about your life? Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Walisema maisha, Yesu alisema nini? Utaamini nani kati ya wao wawili? Bwana asifiwe. Imani yako utaiweka kwa nani? Tumaini lako utalipatiana wapi? Now, let's see the basis of hope. Number one, basis of hope. Number one is God's presence. This one we can get it from the book of Acts that you've read, verse 23, where Paul said, for there stood by me the night, this night, the angel of God, whose I am and whom I serve. In the midst of the storm that we were in, Paul got the courage to encourage these people. And he stood and said, you know what? In last night, the angel of God stood by me, the one that I serve, and he assured me, though we are going to be in this, for the period of the days that we are going to be here, none of us are going to lose our lives. But as if you will. And now, God gives us an opportunity to tell stories of how we choose to believe in him. God gives me and you an opportunity to tell the stories of how we choose to believe in him. For Paul, one opportunity came when traveling with other prisoners by the sea to Italy. And he decided to tell them, you know what, despite what we are going through, mimi kile ninachua tu itaendelea pande, inaendelea pande, na kulingana vile tumesoma umesikia, the ship ilianza kuharibika. Hallelujah. Walifika mahali mpaka wakaanza kutoa mizigo iliyokuwa ndani ya sea and ndani ya ship, wakaanza kutupa nje. At least they lightened the what? The ship. But Paul had one conviction, and the conviction he had was, I have to show these people that there is God that I serve. There is God that I put my trust in. My friends, I want to ask you, in the midst of the storm that you are in, are you telling people of the God that you serve? Ama sisi niwana wenye, tukipitia kakitu, tukidogo hivi, unaanza kutafuta, huyu ni jirani yangu, wamefanya shisho yangu, walikuwa mchawi, siji nini, unaanza kufikiria vitu zenye haziko. Or in the midst of that storm, ama hiyo dhoruba, dhoruba yenye huko, unaweza simama uambie wa, nisa wanapitia hii, mbati naye Mungu ambaye natumainia. Bwana asifiwe. There's one thing that challenges me about our brothers Muslims. During their time for prayer, hata iwe ni sokoni yuko, ama iwe ni kuhoteli, ataenda pale kokoni. Atatandika hata kama ni koti yake aweke pale naanza kusali. Na mnakula, na ingine mnapita hapa, mnafanya, but mimi na Wakristo wenzangu tukienda hata kwa restaurant. Ukiekewa hapo unaangalia kwanza nani angalia nione kama naweza. Unaweza omba tu watu wako wafungua Father in heaven, Jesus, we thank you for the tea before me. Yeah? As in, I cannot tell her, let us pray for our tea. Let's give that to God. I am fearing what will other people say concerning my faith. Amen? Have you been number third whereby these people, it is time for them to pray? Na umelenda shinda. Driver simamisha gari. Kwa nini nataka kusali? Na gari itaafu kusimama kwa pala. Tunelea safari, itasimama for 10 minutes or 20. Paka fanya nini? Wengine wetu wangapi ya tumekuwa tukiwa fasting, then you got a generous passenger. Next, mwenye mumeketi na yeye, hata tukiwa visit na yeye, sasa taki yaone kama mimi mtu mbaya, wacha tu nichukue. If you betray your faith in the midst of any challenge, this Paul did not do it. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Yeye alisema mimi ni mfungwa, yes. Tunaelekea kule tunaelekea, lakini this is my time to show you guys that I have a God. So during a storm, the unbelievers of this ship were ready to do anything to save their life. But Paul expressed his faith by telling them that that an angel of the Lord had promised him that there will be no loss of life. I have come to tell you during this COVID period that we are in, there is none of us going to lose his life or life in Jesus' name. We are not even losing any person of our families or any relative. The angel of the Lord has assured us, is assuring us this hour, that we are not going to lose any one of us in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. I want to go with any declaration that has been made here by the people who have stood and declared that as the elders of Israel counted, none of the people was missing. Even as then, when this one is lifted and every person is accepted or they are allowed to come back to church, we are going to stand here and count, but none of us will be missing in Jesus' name. Na wala tumezoea kuogopa kwenda gari moja kama familia, uwate hiyo ujinga. Na wewe ni Mkristo, nasema kwa madhabahu hiyo ujinga ishe. Kwa sababu, either wende na gari kumi, mimi niende na yangu, wife waende na yake, watoto waende na yao, whatever God has planned, it has to happen. Bwana asifiwe. Na whatever the enemy has planned, if God is not into it, it can't happen. How many times that the enemy has wanted you dead? Do you know? Separately, But you put on at least on the job and happy for Garimota and our total. In case of anything, at least we give our back. What is that anything that you have? Nunga ndabu kisema, I am praying, God, we are praying for safety. And sasa uliombea nini? Because what I believe in, come I pray for the safe journey, we, me and my boo, we enter here, we move. I don't have anything else in my mind. What I have is, I am not going to embark on a journey of no return. I and the people that we are sailing together, and you reach your destination and come back. Praise the Lord. We need to challenge our faith, friends. That now parents who have teenagers, I know this is one of the hardest times that you have. The teenagers, see how wengine, at least wengine weza shautia na katulie. But the teenagers, see how kushautia watulie, unamshautia kwanza na kuangalia. Umesikia? He's like, ah, mamu nimesikia. I know what is happening, you know, you're like, kasi unajua watoto, nasa unajua, mtuto kifika kini, mbaka alete kicho ngumu, mbaka, nani alikuambia, imeandikwa kwa Biblia gani? Ni wapi umeandikiwa hiyo? Bonesa sifiwe. Mtisusa wazazi wako wako kufika secretary, pia wazazi wako wakifika kalaziti mawa wazia kuliatiko wapi. Bwana sifiwe. These are the norms of the enemy that we need to break. And every limitation that the enemy has put our way, we break it in the name of Jesus. We have the covenant in the blood of Jesus. That we are the head and not the tail. We are the first and not the last. So to watoto wao wengine wa familia yenu, hakuna mwenye, yule mwenye tuwa naonekana ni mwalimu, that's the basic course they can choose. So when your daughter, your son says, Mama, I want to be a doctor, you're like, okay. Kwa hii familia ukiangalia, there was not, there has never been, hata kiliniko ofisa. Ana hile, mkarewa naito wale wachini, kafile sekta yenu, hawa wachini, hakuna, unauna tu mwalimu tu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Wapendwa. We need to lift our faith in the Lord amidst any challenge that we are in. And you say, what? I am not looking at the challenge. I am looking at Jesus. Praise God. I love the faith of Stephen. Stefano alipokuwa anagongwa na mawe. Hapo angalia mawe ile mkuu ile mgonga. Alinenda na kainua macho tu na akatazama Mungu. Yeye aliona Mungu. Hakuona mawe. So sisi tunapoanza kukushia tumopa, mbona tunaona mawe wapendwa? Si Mungu atufungie macho tu ya mwili. Atufungue macho ya kiroho. Ili tuweze kumuona yeye tu akiwa ameketi kwenye kiti cha enzi. Praise the Lord. Instead uweze kuona sasa in case corona yende mpaka January, February, March huko. Usianze kuona kuisha kwa kwanza kuona Jehovah akikuinua tena. Na akikufungulia milango ingine ili kukua. Kwa sababu yeye ni Mungu na si mwanadamu. Amen. Praise God. Number two, basis of our faith. It is God's message. God's message. Verse 24, Paul told them, fear not. Fear not, Paul, though I must be brought before Caesar. And God has given me all this that I sail with to assure them of the message of God. Wewe ukiwa kwa mama, ukiwa kwa baba, ukiwa kwa the estate fellowship or the estate hiyo yenu hiyo kwa kikundi ka wale watu wanaishi kwa hiyo estate, do you tell them the powerful God that you serve? Or when they start all complaining that things are not going to work out well, and also you join them to complain things are not going to work out well. Fear not. Isaiah 41 verse 10, the Bible says, fear not, for I am with you. I am your God. Hallelujah. I choose to go with this one, that I fear God, who tells me he is with me. People may leave me, but he may can't. What as if you went? I cannot promise that I walk with you the entire storm that we are in. I am a human being. At times when I get to my house, the issues there, I forget everything and I consider to them. So you, I forget you. But Jesus cannot forget even a single time. Even when you are asleep, he's still carrying you through. Even when you are coming to an end, he's still holding you. But me and me, naangalia una hope, you are there na wewe. What our pendant make imani yetu kwa Mungu, aliye tuita. Amen. Sharing about your trust in God can bring hope to people who are in difficult situations. When somebody comes to you as an unbeliever or even a fellow believer and they start sharing their difficulties with you, What are you doing? Or you share still, you also share yours. Share with them how able is our God. That you may lift them again. One as if you were, and they are able to see the light at the end of the tunnel. Number three, God's love is will never change. God's love will never change. Number three, basis of our hope. God's love will never change. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, so that whoever believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. If God gave his only son for me and for you, and as a ransom for many and for our sin, what does that make you think that Jehovah anaenda kukuachilia kwa hiyo ambayo unapitia wakati kama huu? Unahitaji uinue imani yako kwake. Umwambie kama Mungu wewe ndio uliyemtuma mwana wako pekee. Aje hapa duniani kwa ajili ya mimi. Jehova anakuangalia. Hata kama hiyo boti inasafiria currently imeingia maji kama ile wanafunzi wa Yesu, muite Yesu. Muangalie tu. Bwana asifiwe. I usually make one a dangerous prayer every day. I tell God, but if I would die, I would rather lose my last breath hoping in you. Because Romans tells me 12 that the hope that I have in the Lord does not disappoint. So if I keep on hoping in the Lord, I will never be disappointed. Disappointment will come around me, but if I put my complete trust in the Lord, it will never, never bring me down. Hallelujah. And that's where I want us to move. So, number 4 or 5, God's purpose will never change. Romans 8:29, for the gifts of God, the gift and the calling of God are without repentance. They are irrevocable. Whatever the purpose God had for you when he created you, you'll never change that unless you change you alone. And what will happen unless you leave him and go to the world and start doing other things? But regardless of hayo mawimbi yanaweza kuwa unapitia, bado Mungu wetu hawezi badilisha mawazo yake kuhusu maisha yako. Kama alisema atakubariki, hata nani akuje, he has to bless you. Kama alisema atakuinua, hata nani apige, bado Yehova atafanya nini? Atakuinua. Tuko pamoja wapendwa. So God's purpose for our life will never change. God's support will never leave us. Hebrews 13:5 says, for I will never leave you nor forsake you. Mungu wetu anasema ya kwamba hawatawahi tuacha na hawatawahi tuachilia. Ni kwa nini unafika mahali umefika mwisho unaanza kuachilia Mungu? Ukiachilia Mungu mpendo utaumia. Usiwachilie Mungu. Hallelujah. Mshikilie tu. Napenda Rose Muhando. Anasema kama tapindo la Yesu mshikilie. Usimwachilie aende, unamwachilia aende wapi? Unaona kina Paul? Wakati walikuja kutoka kwa hiyo ship ni wakati walifikia to an island called Malta. Walipoona hapa kuna ground we can now, there's an island we can now walk into. Wakania after now that the ship ilikuja kwa sababu hapa sasa uko karibu na ufuo wa bahari. What we can do, we can swim to that island. At the time waliamua kutoka kwa hiyo ship. But before, hata kama ilikuwa na shida mingi, none of them got out. The same way the disciples of Jesus, when that storm arose, none of them got out of the boat. Hallelujah. Wewe unaacha Yesu unakimbia wapi? Unakimbia kwa nani? Tusikubali. Hallelujah. Now, what steals our hope? Hope steals us. Number one, there are storms of different types in life, especially the extended storms. I just told me it's a good 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 1 year, 3 years. When that one it extends, it may tend to steal your hope in the Lord. But I want to encourage you, even if it extends for 30 years, don't allow it to steal your hope in the Lord. Bwana asifiwe. Siku moja Jehova atakuja na atakuinua. Na utasimama mbele ya watu na utasema kile ambacho Mungu ametenda. Yesterday I was in the office with somebody that received God during this COVID period around the month of March, and he came and told me, Rev, before you visited us in the family and you prayed with us, before I gave my life to Jesus, we used to fight in this house. I used to come and a lot of kelele mingi for my wife and the children. and there was no peace in this home until the day God sent you to that home. You came with prayer and I gave my life to Jesus. I tell you, there is a lot of peace in that home. There is a lot of calmness. When we have, we don't have, we feel we are okay and we live, we continue living life every day. But it told me before things were not okay. Hallelujah. So I want to tell you, kuna mwisho wa hiyo safari yenye unapitia. Kuna mwisho wa hiyo mawimbi, hayo mawimbi ambayo uko ndani yake. Mwisho wake utafika. Na ukifika, Jehovah atakupatia rest. Praise the Lord. Number two, problems. Problems are also fillers of our hope. Mashinda. Problems that seems bigger than your faith. Kuna kishinda kinaweza kuja kukiangalia kishinda kikubwa ni kikubwa zaidi ya imani yako. Na hapo inafika nasema, never allow your problem to be bigger than your God. Allow your God to be bigger than that mountain or that problem. When you see it that way, you are able to. One thing that challenges me in life, hadigiriri. Okay, so I'm not hadigiri, I'm not allowed to sit with. Sio kwa maitanga, sisimizi, nikitumia Kiswahili mtaelewa. Au kamdudu kadogo, ama the beetle. The beetle is of this size. But unajua beetle, ataenda tafuta cow dung. Ataitengeneza round, na ataipandisha mlima. Ushio na ikifanya hivyo. Wende utafuta, wangalia, angalia pale kuna ng'ombe uone. Inapandisha, unajua inapandisha, ipandisha hivi, inapandisha na nyuma. So miguu ya mbele iko huku, inachukuma huku. Uni, this thing is so tiny, but the Lord it is carrying, it is very big. Kwa hiyo bito, hiyo load ikiwa big, inajionanga ikiwa big, kubeba hii load. Can we have such a faith on, in the Lord? Ukiona hiki kimlima sawa kimesimama hapa, but unaona nini mbele yako? Unaona pale kimlima unaona Mungu? Wapendo, na Jehovah ni mwaminifu. Sickness are also fillers of our hope. Again, especially the extended sickness. Unaweza kuwa na mgonjwa umemuombea, 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 ni kama you are giving up. Don't give up on God. Ujui Mungu atamponya lini. Endelea kumuombea Mungu atakuja kumchukua, mchukue. But never give up on that. Hallelujah. Broken relationships. Marriages. They also tend to steal our hope. If you married, the first marriage never worked, and in the second one, don't, when you see things coming up, don't start now thinking of the first one that broke. If you have ever suffered a broken relationship, don't allow it to steal your hope in God. Still you make it. Na utaolewa na harusi kama ulikuwa umepanga hivyo. Bwana asifiwe. Kama mtu wa kwanza alikufrustrate, maanisha wa pili watatu atakufrustrate. Wa pili pia anaweza kuwa kama wa kwanza, but watatu Yehova atasimama. Bwana asifiwe. Vijana mnanisikia? Don't allow to take any shortcut. There is God in heaven whom you serve. He can come through for you. Amen. Na wale wazazi ambao watoto wetu wamepata wazazi watoto nyumbani, usikufe moyo. Bado ni mtoto wako. Yes, ni mtoto wako bado. Tunasikizana. Wazana sisi tuongea wale tunajua kuongea. Wale tupeleke kwa Citizen na MTV na KTN, tupeleke huko. But huyo ni mtoto wako, mtunze na umpende. Na Jehovah bado ako na hatima ya maisha yake. Mimi sina. Yesu ako? Ako nayo. Hallelujah. Kuna wale wengine tumesoma masomo yamefikia katikati fizi kapotea. Kuna Mungu mbinguni. Au utaishi hivyo, utamaliza katika jina la Yesu. Inua imani yako kwa Mungu. What causes the causes? What causes the storms? Not every storm we experience is our fault. One, some people refusing to listen to God's instructions, like the way Paul instructed his fellow prisoners not to sail at that time, but they sailed. Number two, poor choices. Una make a very wrong choice. It can also cause a storm, ignoring the seasons. When you see, you know, you need to be very sensitive because of the season. You know what kind of a season you are in. You might be in your ripe season, then you ignore that. Ikupite. Na ujue season yao ikupite, ni vigumu sana kuirejelea tena. Unless Mungu asimame. Desiring comfort over safety. You need to have safety first before you start desiring the comfort. When you are safe, you can now go to that comfort. Basic decision on temporary situations can also cause a storm. doing things we know are reckless, especially that God says we should not. Finally, what hope does, I come to the end and then we pray. Number one, hope encourages. Kile tumaini nafanya ni kutia moyo. Inakutia moyo kwa haya mashida yenye uko. And now I exhort you to be of good cheer, for there shall be no loss of any man's life among you, but the sheep. This is what Paul told them in verse 22. Hope helps us to remember we are never out of God's reach. The hope helps us to remember that you are never out of God's reach. The angel of the Lord found the sheep and the apostle even in the midst of the storm. If God could find Paul in the midst of the storm, how about you, the child of God? Number two, hope restores the expectation. That which you had expected and now you find it is coming to an end. Faith can restore it again. Hope can restore it again. Hope gives us energy. Gives us back energy to pray, to serve God, and to continue hoping in the Lord. Hope gives us purpose for our lives. Hope in a kupatia purpose, that's why you cannot give up. Hope helps us to make it through the valley. When you see your way through the valley, it is only hope that can help you stand again so that you can start climbing to the mountain. And finally, hope helps us to look behold our present and look toward the future. It is hope that helps me and you to stop looking the present circumstances. As Paul is saying in Romans 8:18, that our present circumstances cannot be compared to the glory to be revealed. So, ambia mwenye, okay, mneza ambia mwenye wakalibu na kuangalia vizuri tu wakati kama huu. Vini tuwa na kuona hivyo, mpamwambia kupatia munda, Jehovah anapokuja kukuinua, akikutana na wewe tena hata realize kama ni wewe. Bwana asifiwe. Mr. Peter, najua kuna watu mlisoma nao kukutana na wewe saa hizi hawezi amini ni wewe. Vini tuwa likuwa mekuona. And I like giving an example of myself. There is somebody who told me that he was so worried about my life because I would live a very reckless life. Na alikuwa ananihurumia sana. But God proved him wrong. When we met with him, I was very smart and he called me, he looked like an old mzee. Then I'm like, oh mzee, ananijua aje. Tells me, don't you remember when we were schooling with you? I'm like, Jesus, be aware. Because the guy went and drank himself out and he looked so old. But God is so faithful, I had to remind him that statement he made. He told him, look at yourself and look at me, who is now living a reckless life. He told me, I wish I listened when you always told us in church, we keep quiet, together see you, you used to make noise and all that. I told him, still there is time, there is still a chance for you, you can still turn, but can never say anything upon me. He wanted to just call an option. Bwana asifiwe. So kama uko hapa na kuna watu wamekuangalia tu wakamalizana na wewe usijali, wachana wao sio Mungu. Bwana asifiwe. Wengine wetu tunaomba Mungu atupatie watoto, aidha uko na wasichana peke yake, naomba Mungu akupe kijana, uko na vijana naomba Mungu akupe kijana. Whatever that you're praying for, wengine hawana kazi, naomba Jehovah tu akupe. Wachana na wale ambao wanakuangalia wakikudiscourage. Look at God. Don't look at this present situation around you. If you look at that, you die. Look at God. Look at your future. That is in God's blood and hands. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Usikubali mtu yote akuwekee maisha yako full stop. Kwa pamoja, tusimameni. Don't allow any man or any woman to put a full stop into your life. They never began it. It is God who began your life. So let him put a full stop at his own appointed time. Praise the Lord. Yes. Friends, never allow any man or any woman to be the last one to talk. Let God be the last one to talk.
Hallelujah. Wewe Bwana umenishangaza. Umenishangaza.
Help you to go through that storm. It is only Jesus who can hold your heart and make you move through. Ni Yesu peke yake anaweza kusaidia katika hayo mawimbi ama katika dhoruba ya maisha wakati ship ama ama boti yako imeingia maji ni Yesu peke yake anaweza kushikilia na kuongoza mpaka ufikie mwisho usikubali wanadamu wakuweke chini kubali Mungu akuinue pale ambapo unaona wanadamu wanakuweka chini bado wanashindwa na wewe kubali Mungu peke yake akaweze kukuonekana na akaweze kukuhifadhi maana yeye ni mwema na anastahili sifa za moyo wako Yehova tunakuinua tunakupa sifa tunakutukuza na kukuimbi tunasema wewe ni Mungu na hakuna mwingine kama wewe tumekutumainia siku nyingi tumekuona Mungu utatuatilia tumekuona utatuibisha tumekuona mfalme ukitenda maajabu na miujiza na tunainua sauti zetu kwako wakati kama huu tukitema ya kwamba katika yale mawimbi tulio ndani yake katika dhoruba za maisha Bwana unaenda kutuinua unaenda kututetea tena unaenda Mungu wa neema kuinua mioyo yetu tena katika jina la Yesu Kristo wengine wetu Mungu tuliangaliwa na tukaibishwa wengine tukaangaliwa na tukaonekana kama hatufai lakini sisi tunafaa mbele zako pokea sifa na utukufu maana wewe ndio uliye na jawabu letu la mwisho wewe ndio uliye na maisha yetu ya baadaye tunakuinulia mikono tunakuinulia imani yetu tunainua mikono yetu juu tukikiri ya kwamba wewe unatosha na hakuna Mungu mwingine kama wewe wastahili sifa za moyo wetu mfalme katika jina la Yesu Kristo restore our faith in you again restore our faith in you again encourage us again dear Lord that we are able to make it in Jesus precious name Father in every storm that we are in I pray for your hope in Jesus name let's see you Jesus who is able to do things that no man can do let's look at help us to look at you Lord who is able to carry us through this storm of life in the name of Jesus Christ we love you Son of God and we praise you because you are faithful and a wonderful God We honor you because you rewards all those who seek you diligently. Even as we seek you, dear Master, we pray, reward us again in the name of Jesus. Lord, look at this man, look at this lady, look at this young person who has been watching and listening as Jehovah Master, they are going through a turmoil. We pray, Father, may you speak a word of hope again and restore them in the name of Jesus Christ. Get a hold of their hands because if they go, get a hold of your hand, Lord, they are going to release you. Father, when you get hold of their hands, you're going to make them reach their destiny in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare every delayed blessing, every delayed breakthrough, every delayed manifestation of your grace, Abba Father, upon our lives. May you actualize it now in Jesus' name. We love you, Son of God, and we praise you. Thank you because of our online viewers, Jehovah, who have been watching and listening to us. We pray for them that whatever the promise through that it wait for them and make themselves through to your own glory in the name of Jesus whether it's financial whether it's health wise Lord whether it's peace in their families God of mercy we pray do it because you are the Lord we appreciate you and we honor you in Jesus precious and loving name that we pray and we give thanks amen and amen I want us to pray and to pray for you Lift the hands.
Hallelujah. Wewe Bwana umenishangaza.